like, subscribe and hit the bell icon for prior notifications.
Hello everyone. In this class, we are going to discuss about the process of implantation. Implantation occurs after cleavage. So cleavage, we have discussed in the previous class that it is a period of rapid mitotic division, after which from zygote blastula is formed. Blastula or blastocyst is formed. So that is the structure like this. This is the structure of a blastocyst or blastula. By the day of 6th, it is completely formed and it is present inside the uterine cavity now. The blastocyst is inside the uterine cavity. So what will happen next? So next event is implantation. Implantation is the attachment or embedding of the blastocyst on the uterine endometrium. So this is the uterine endometrial layer. So embedding of the blastocyst or attachment of the blastocyst is called implantation. So implantation is the embedding or attachment of the blastocyst on the endometrium. So you can see here the zona pellucida is disintegrating due to the action of the proteolytic enzyme secreted by the trophoblastic cells. So after finding a proper implantation site, what happens? The trophoblastic cells, they release or they secrete proteolytic substances and that dissolve this zona pellucida layer. And these cells of trophoblast, which are in contact with the inner cell mass, these are called cells of rubber, and these are the trophoblastic cells. So after, what will happen after disintegration of the zona pellucida? The cells of rubber, so these are the kind of trophoblast only, the trophoblasts. So what will happen, this trophoblast, the trophoblastic cells, they multiply rapidly and they are forming two distinct layers. So those layers are called cytotrophoblast and syncytiotrophoblast. This is syncytiotrophoblast. So now the trophoblastic cells, they divide and differentiate into two further layers, cytotrophoblast and syncytiotrophoblast. Cytotrophoblast, that layer is made up of distinct cells having distinct cell boundaries, but syncytiotrophoblast here, this is the syncytiotrophoblast, which is formed by a multinucleated structure like this, multinucleated branched structure like this, due to the fusion of the plasma membrane of the cells, trophoblastic cells. And syncytium term means a multinucleated structure, that's why it is called syncytiotrophoblast. Usually this is developed from the cells of rubber. So what will happen next? This multinucleated branch structure try to invade the endometrium through this intercellular area. This branch structure try to invade the endometrium. Simultaneously, what will happen, it also releases certain proteolytic factors or enzymes which will digest the endometrium or endometrial cells. What will happen, a pit is formed gradually, and the whole structure, the blastocyst, gradually sinks into it. So here you can see gradually the blastocyst is trying to penetrate the uterine endometrium, and remember this is the stratum functionalis layer. We have discussed the above layers of the upper layers of uterine endometrium, or the inner layer of uterine endometrium is of stratum functionalis. So the blastocyst, now it tries to penetrate the uterine endometrium through its syncytiotrophoblast. and the proteolytic enzyme secreted by the syncytial trophoblastic cells, which digest the nearby endometrial cells, and the site PT is formed through which the complete structure sinks. And finally, this structure is now inside the endometrium. So this kind of implantation, when the blastocyst is completely buried inside the endometrium, is called interstitial implantation. Remember, in case of humans, the kind of implantation is called interstitial implantation. So by the day of ninth, the blastocyst is completely buried inside the endometrial wall. So this occurs, the attachment occurs by the day of 7 after fertilization, and by the day of 9 after fertilization, there is complete burial of the blastocyst. You can see there is a slight change in the inner cell mass also, this inner cell mass. This change we are going to study in the process of gastrulation. Don't worry about that here. So, and another important thing you should remember, that the implantation or attachment should occur on the inner cell mass side, or the embryonic pole of the blastocyst should attach with the endometrial wall, so that there will be space for the fetal development inside the endometrium only, and the trophoblastic cell layer is going to form the boundary. This trophoblastic cell layer is going to form the extra embryonic membrane, that is chorion and amnion, surrounding the embryo. So this is all about the process of implantation or attachment. So what will happen next? So this implantation now results in pregnancy. This is the beginning of the pregnancy, or we can say now conception has occurred, conception, conception and has occurred, and the person or the female is called as pregnant. So how will know that implantation has occurred? So there is usually a missed period, that is a missed menstrual cycle, and the female goes for a check of urine, and that urine check is called Gravidex test, that is called Gravidex test. That is a kind of urine test in which there is, usually we check the presence of HCG hormone. So what is HCG? So HCG is human chorionic gonadotropin hormone. Human chorionic gonadotropin hormone, that is secreted by the trophoblastic cells only. Gonadotropin. So from when this HCG is secreted, when the trophoblastic cell layer is formed in the blastocyst, from then only HCG secretion begins, but in a mild amount, very little amount of HCG is secreted. Gradually the HCG secretion becomes more and more, and the syncytial trophoblastic cells here, they secrete more amount of HCG, more and more amount of HCG, and this HCG is now secreted in the urine, excreted in the urine by the next cycle, by next menstrual cycle. So if there is presence of HCG in urine, it is indicative of the implantation of the blastocyst or pregnancy. That means it is HCG is taken as diagnostic tool for pregnancy. So what is the function of HCG? It is the indicator hormone of pregnancy, and the main function of HCG during this period is it stimulates the corpus luteum, which is present inside the ovary, to produce more and more progesterone, so that the uterine endometrium here will remain intact and will provide nourishment to the developing embryo. So what is the function of HCG? Human chorionic gonadotropin hormone, or HCG, stimulates the corpus luteum, which is present inside the ovary, to secrete more and more progesterone to make the thickness of the uterine endometrium and to provide nourishment to the growing embryo. So this is all about the process of implantation. Later we'll discuss about the growth of the embryo under gastrulation.